Good morning, Payne County, Father Brian O'Brien. It's Friday morning after Ash Wednesday. We've had a little bit of a rough week here at the parish. We had some water damage that was sustained on Wednesday evening, right after all the Ash Wednesday masses were going on. And I just want to explain what happened, just to give everyone, just want everybody to be in the know. We don't want any rumors going around, but it basically, there's some damage, but we're open. We had a great day yesterday getting things cleaned up and making sure that everything is safe. And so we are on. Stations of the Cross today at 11, Mass at 12:10, Stations of the Cross again at 6, Stations of the Cross in Spanish at 7:30. Everything scheduled for this weekend is on. The Mass schedule, Saturday 5, Sunday 7, 8:30, 11:15, and Spanish at 1 o'clock is on. There's some snow, you can see, look at all this. We got great snow out here. And so the parking lot is not, you know, totally clear, especially the area over by the rectory. Is not clear, but other than that, there's plenty of parking and we are ready to roll. Okay, so I want to share with you what happened on Wednesday. And it all starts way up here at the very top of our beautiful bell tower that you can see for miles and miles around. Up in the close to the top of the bell tower, there is a sprinkler head. And with the cold, as many of you have experienced with the cold, that sprinkler head, we think, froze and broke. So in a sprinkler system, there's water in it all the time. I've learned a lot about sprinkler systems lately. There's water in it all the time because it has to be ready to douse a fire. So what happened when that broke is all of that water had to go somewhere. And so where it went, unfortunately for us, is straight down that the spire. So down it came. So this was about a little after 9 o'clock Wednesday night, and there was just this sound right up above in the hallway here of like rushing water. And we were like, what the heck is that? Anyway, so come on inside and I just want to show you the damage. And I think what you're gonna see is actually not very much. I think you might probably be expecting bigger damage, but I think a lot of it is gonna be kind of inside between the choir loft and the narthex ceiling. But come on in here. Okay, come this way here. So we were, I was kind of standing around right here, and I heard this like water, like rushing over my head. And then we started to hear like water dripping, like it was like a hard rain almost. That was kind of the sound. So come on into the chapel. So just as you know, the chapel is going to be closed for a little while as we figure out how best to do with it. But come on in here and I'll show you what's going on. So come on in. You'll notice the altar is gone. The Mother Teresa statue is gone. They're safe. That was one of the first things we did, was to pick them up and move them. But right here in this corner, there was water pouring out of that spot and just pouring down to the ground. And it was very, very concerning as it was happening. Because we're like, where is it coming from? What's happening? Then a little bit later on, water also started coming out of this corner here, and it came down onto the pew. So there's some water damage on that back pew back there. And there was about an inch of water on the floor in here, which has all been cleaned up. And it will be ready to go once we figure out what we're going to do here and here, and then get the altar and the Blessed Sacrament back in. So that's the chapel. Yeah. Okay, so back out into the hallway here. So this carpet right here got pretty wet. It has been dried out. Lots of shop vacs and high pressure air, but it did not reach anything into the parish office, and it did not make it down the hallway, did not make it into our school, did not make it into the youth center, any of that. So then you come in here, and this is probably the most concerning area because there was water all up above here. So there was water pouring through these lights and then through these vents right here. And then there were several spots, so come on over here, and you can see these holes here and spots here. There was water just coming out of there, gallons and gallons and gallons of water. So if you were to come in here Wednesday night, 11 o'clock, there would have been 10 or 12 gray trash cans in here just catching water. And what we moved out all the tables, we moved the welcome table, and tried to just allow the water to come down without damaging the integrity of the ceiling. So the big areas of damage, probably some of you, when you come in these front doors, you probably don't even look up. So if you didn't know we had this, and if you didn't look up, you would not know anything was wrong. But you can see kind of over here, these spots here, and then some damage here to these kind of beams that are going across. These were all full of water. And so we actually, at different times, just had to try to alleviate that pressure. So that's basically the damage. So there was water in between here, and then right up above us is the choir loft. So let's take a walk up to the choir loft, and we'll just show you what's happening. Come on up. So welcome to the choir loft. There was water coming out of that room up there. So that room is right up above, right down below where the water issue was. So there was water coming down here. Now, we don't think there has been any damage up here. We took the organ and put it up on books so that the organ wouldn't get damaged. A lot of the electrical equipment for live streaming and for music, we just put it up into a higher place. And then there was just a lot of cleanup, a lot of drying, a lot of shop vacuuming, a lot of squeegeeing that allowed for this space to now be dry and to be able to be used. That's really it. I don't know, I hope we didn't make it sound more dramatic than it was, but it was pretty dramatic Wednesday night. Dramatic and perhaps traumatic. But through a lot of hard work of our staff and a lot of hard work of some volunteers that were up here yesterday, we're able to be back open. So, Stations of the Cross today at 11, Mass today at 12:10, Stations of the Cross tonight at 6, Spanish Stations at 7:30, and then the full weekend schedule. If you have questions about any of this, feel free. Father Robert and I will be around. Some of our staff will be around this weekend. We're happy to answer any questions. We have a restoration team coming who's going to give us an honest assessment of what's happening, what needs to be fixed or rebuilt, or we don't know yet. And then, of course, we've been in touch with our insurance company, and we'll work through all the financials of that, and we'll kind of keep you posted as we go along. That's the story from 7-Eleven North Country Club. So hope you have a great day. Hope we see you at Stations, we see you at Mass today and this weekend. And we love you and pray for us as we're praying for you. I hope your Lent is off to a great start. And it's Friday, so don't even eat today. Okay, bye.